Hello, everyone. Welcome back. It's Ralph Humphrey, and this is another episode of Rhythmic Awareness. As promised, I want to get into the music of Frank Zappa, especially his rhythmic concepts. So, with a lot of music that we listen to, there's an organization that we understand. By that, I mean you can tap your foot to the beat. The phrases are easily understood. You can even dance to it. And Frank wrote a lot of that kind of music. But he also wrote a lot of music that did not have the usual beat structure. In fact, a lot of the music sounds like it exists in space somehow, in some sort of time frame. This is what I want to talk about today by showing you an example of a segment of a tune called Timurshi Dween. I don't know what that means. I should have asked Frank when I had the chance. All right. Anyhow, I want you to listen to this piece of music that I'm going to play for you shortly and see what you can do to figure out what's going on here. All right. The phrase gets repeated several times, and then there's a little drum sort of fill, and then gets repeated again. And so what I want to do is play it for you now, and then we'll check it out on the other side and talk about it. Here we go. Sorry, that's all you get. You want to hear more? Go see the movie, Roxy the Movie, which was recorded in 1974. But the movie didn't come out but a few years ago. And this was because there was an issue with audio and video synchronization at the time. The album Live at the Roxy and Elsewhere did come out shortly after we recorded that. And that's a great record. So this music comes from the same concert. Live at the Roxy, a club in Los Angeles, California. All right, getting back to this particular segment, how do we hear it? Okay, now many of you who enjoy Frank's music simply enjoy Frank's music. You're not interested in structural elements of rhythm, the melodic content, what's going on there. You just like how it sounds. But if you're interested in rhythm, you'll want to know what's going on. All right, so here's the way I want to hear it. First of all, the cycle, and that's exactly what we hear here, is a cycle of notes. There's groupings, okay? And how do you hear groupings of notes? You look for the stress notes in the melody, in the rhythm, the notes that are the targets, okay? So the way I hear this is 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2. Da 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 da. Okay, now let's add all that up. 1 2 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 equals the answer 23. That's an odd number. That's a weird number. Okay, well, if this was written out, you'd probably use the 16th note, which would mean the time signature is 23/16. So each individual note in that phrase is the beat. Okay, this is how Frank wrote. In fact, you know, I don't know that this was written out or not for the band. I can't recall. A lot of times we would rehearse. He would spoon feed the information to the band. We would memorize it and never write it down. Other music, however, that Frank wrote, he would write it out note for note. The Black Page drum solo is an example of that, where the written music was precise in terms of its orchestration on the drum set. In this particular Timurshi Dween example, we, the drummers, myself and Chester Thompson, had the privilege of orchestrating it the way we wanted to orchestrate it. Frank only was interested in us playing the rhythm correctly, all right? So there was some leeway a lot of times in that regard, and it gave me some leeway in terms of how I wanted to lay it out on the drum set. So Now you have a better understanding of this kind of a phrase that Frank would write in a lot of other music that he wrote. And we might look into some of that in a later episode. By the way, Roxy the Movie is the same band that did Live at the Roxy and elsewhere. And this particular band also recorded a live concert on Halloween 1973 in Chicago. And this is a package that came out recently, a 4-CD package with extensive liner notes written by Ruth Underwood, Joe Travers, and myself. Very, really interesting package. Comes replete with a mask of Frank Zappa. All right. So I hope this gives you some insight into Frank's style of music and gives you a way in which to hear some of the more complicated passages of his music. So until the next time, I hope you have a great day. Take care.